Algorithm and Flowchart. Quick introduction. You all know that computer is an electronic machine with no thinking of its own. To solve any problem, it requires some instructions that guide it, what is to be done, and how to do it. These instructions are called programs. And these programs are written by programmers. In this chapter, you will learn about algorithms and flowcharts that help us to deliver instructions to the computer. Algorithm is not a computer program, but it simply tells how to logically write a program. Algorithm is a collection of steps that are required to solve a problem. Flowchart is a graphical representation of algorithm, which simplifies the algorithm and makes it easy to understand. Way to problem solving. Let's start with an example which will make you understand the steps in problem solving. The manager of a restaurant wants his executive, Mr. Karthik, to find out the total amount of money available in the restaurant's account each night. Now, Mr. Karthik performs the following steps. Step 1. Mr. Karthik creates a flowchart on the basis of which he will write a program. Step 2. With the help of the flowchart, he starts writing the program. Step 3. He inputs the program into the computer. Step 4. While testing his program, Mr. Karthik finds some errors. He corrects those errors and checks if the program is correct. Step 5. When the program is found to be completely correct, he inserts the input and gets the output. Let's see how problem solving has been done. Step 1. First of all, create an algorithm or a flowchart. Step 2. Write the program in any computer language. Step 3. Input the program into the computer. Step 4. Debug the whole program and find out if any error occurs or not. Step 5. If program is correct, then insert the input and wait for the output. Algorithm. Algorithm is a set of instructions that are written in an order to solve a problem. The instructions must be followed in a proper way in order to solve the problem. You can apply algorithms in your day-to-day life also. Let us see some examples of writing algorithm. Algorithm to add two numbers. Step 1. Start. Step 2. Read the two numbers. Step 3. Add the two numbers and store the result as total. Step 4. Print the total value. Step 5. Stop. Algorithm to read a book. Step 1. Start. Step 2. Take out the book from your bag. Step 3. Open your book. Step 4. See the table of contents. Step 5. Choose the chapter that you want to read. Step 6. Open your chosen chapter and start reading your lesson. Step 7. Stop where you have finished reading the entire lesson. Flowchart. Flowchart is a pictorial representation of the algorithm written to solve the problem. You can also say that flowchart is a graphical representation of algorithm. It is very necessary to draw the flowchart according to logic and in the simplest way. There are different symbols that are used to draw the flowchart. The size of a flowchart depends upon the type of the problem. The logic should be clear so that anyone can easily understand. There are some special symbols which are used for drawing a flowchart. The symbols and their applications are as given. Flowchart symbols. Terminal box. The terminal box is the starting point in a flowchart. So, it is called a start or stop box. This box is used in the beginning or at the end of any program. This is oval in shape, and while creating a flowchart, you can write start or end inside this oval. Input-output box. The input-output box in a flowchart is just like a parallelogram in shape. To make any type of input in the computer or to display any type of output, this box is used to write inside it. The statements like input, print, etc. of basic language are used to type inside this box. Process box. The process box is rectangular in shape, where all the steps involving processing work are written inside it. To calculate the numbers or to assign some values to variables, this process box is used. In one process box, only one step is written, so you can use as many boxes one by one related to the number of processing steps to be taken. Connector. Connector is circular in shape, which is used to connect two statements situated at different places in a program. This is very useful to show the connection of different parts of a flowchart made on different pages. Flow lines. Flow lines in a flowchart are the arrows which connect the two boxes and determine the flow or sequence of the instructions used in a program. These flow lines generally flow from top to bottom and from left to right. Decision box. Decision box is like a diamond in shape. Decision making is done inside it. In this box, all types of comparisons between the objects can be made. For example, if you want to compare the age of two friends in a class, then the statement which you can write inside it is like, is the age of first friend greater than the age of second friend? Therefore, this box purely gives the decision between two or more objects. Examples of flowchart. Some examples are here to show the flowchart with statements inside the boxes. Thus, it is clear that it is easy to draw a flowchart and make the final steps instead of directly writing the program and make changes in it. Rules to draw a flowchart. Basic rules that should be followed while drawing flowcharts are: the symbol for start and stop should always be there. Always focus on the direction of your flowchart. It should be either left to right or top to bottom. Always think logically and try to find the best way to solve the problem.